I think it's time for a worm farm update from Freida's garden. So come on with me and we'll give this a try. Now what I do is I have this little thing I had left from my business, and also a tripod this time for the camera, which I'm using my regular camera now. This is getting really heavy. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull it out, put it on this table, open it up, but I have to put the camera on. So I'll be back. Hello. Just checking if it's good. Okay, I'm back. Let's take this off and the flies. Now, I mean, that's, I said flies because I'm not too sure if those are, everybody always talks about fruit flies. But I don't know, they look like gnats to me. So anyway, I'm gonna like this so it shades it just a touch. That doesn't seem to be working. So maybe a little. Anyway, I have this on top. Here's what I've done. Can you see this? Put my hand right here. Yes. Okay, what I did was I kind of moved everything up this way. I fed them my leftover worm food. Not really worm food, but it's from my juicing. I've been feeding them over on this side. Because I thought, okay, if I get them that side, I could push this all forward since it's going down. Push this all forward and then put new bedding. Well, I spent a long time putting up new bedding and dampening it up a little bit. Lots of gnats out here. Make sure worms are on here. Sorry about the trash truck. They are very inconsiderate, these cars. They don't know that I pretend like I'm living on a farm in the city. Anyway, there's a little baby right there. Oh, I'm sorry. You know, I'm getting so I'm really feeling for these worms. Like, if they get out in the sun, I feel like it's burning them, so it creeps me out. Anyway, I'm just getting way too attached to my worms, I think. So what I did was I put new bedding in. Here, I'll show you up close. See if I can see this. One thing I know is when people are making these videos with worms, sometimes you just want them to hold it still for a minute. And so I made this netting. Let's see if anybody's over here. They're probably over there with the food. Made this new bedding and I put it over here. So there's just bedding over here. So if they want to get away from all that food, they can, because they're thinking, you know, maybe they want to get away from it. Anyway, I did cardboard and paper. And the compost that you're seeing there is because I took some of it and I just put it on top of this. So, there's a worm over in the new stuff. Cool. Okay, that's all I wanted to see. So this about from here on, it's all new stuff. And then I pushed everything over here. And it, you know, it used to be pretty high, so it's going down and getting heavier. So that must be combined with all the worm bee or something. I don't know. Oh, come on, baby. Sorry. I don't know. I'm getting so I don't handle them so rough as I did. And I try to keep them out of the shade. I mean, I try to keep them out of the sun. All right, let's just take a quick look. And one thing I realize, oh yeah, is that I want to hold it still. And I don't want to ruffle them up too much, but wow, they in heaven. They love my leftover juice stuff. And they are having fun. So, let's see. I'll just come down here a little bit. There you go. They seem to be okay. What do you think, garbage guru number one? What do you think? They doing good? I don't see any problems. This is sort of the middle ground here. Oh, and I see some here too. All right, I don't want to mess with them anymore. I don't, you know, I used to sort of down in them and everything. And I wish I could see a cocoon though. You think that's a cocoon? Right there? Huh. Don't you just love looking at the dirt? You know, I took all of my compost out of my regular compost bin and I made a new, and when I did that, I just planted some things in that garden and I couldn't believe how many worms are in there. I'm thinking about, and they all look like red little worms to me, but I'm thinking about taking one of those worms and putting beside one of these worms, seeing if I can really see the difference, because I have a hard time telling the difference in worms. Although Garbage Guru, number one, I just watched your video and I saw the tiger, so I could see a tiger worm. Let me see. Does mine have stripes? Come on, one worm. Oh, babies. Does it have stripes? No stripes. Wait, I'll put you in the shade, sorry. No stripes. Huh. I don't see no stripes, so you're not a stripe one. You're the red worm. Oh, sorry. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, go back down. I say I'm sorry to the worms too much. You think I'm just a little obsessed with them? All right, and now on top I had this paper, so I'll put the paper back. So this worm bin seems to be going fine. I haven't dusted to the other worm bin, but let's look at that one. I'll be back. Okay, I'm back with the second one. This one's over there. See back there? And my second one, I'm gonna open up now. I want you to watch how many gnats managed to get through these little tiny holes on the side. Well, I used to be afraid that there wasn't enough air, but I look at the gnats. Can you see them? Get a little care. Come on. Just hold still. I know I have this. Gotta get this a little closer. Sorry. All right, that's as close as it's gonna get. All right. Anyway, a little shade in there. So there was a lot of gnats in here, and you can see because they're all. And you see, they're all stuck to the top of that for some reason. Whoops. I forgot to look, see if there's any worms on there. Okay. All right, this one, I have not made a particular section with new stuff. Oh yeah, this one I had down at this end. Oh, all right, I'm gonna try to hold it still. Let me shut this up. Holding it still is a good thing. All right, look at that. Now I've been feeding this one at this end. Actually, I've been feeding it both ends. See, they seem to be doing okay. Holy shit, look at all the worms. Oh, babies, they love my leftover juicing stuff. Okay, I'm excited. I don't want to bother them much, but I feel like I'm scorching. Okay, Garbage Guru said, like, don't bother them too much. And I really value that. I think I was just so wanting to see them. I dig down too much, and I try to be very gentle. I don't want to hurt anybody, and I don't want them to die. So this, well, I think I put the new stuff in on the other side. This would be the colder end too. So maybe they like the warmth. I wonder if these are too long. I got tired of doing the whole shredding thing. Sometimes you put a lot of work into things that you don't really need to do that, but you know, you gotta try everything. So these guys, oh, sorry, guy, go down in there. Okay, here we go. That's my second worm bin, and they seem to be doing happy, very happy now. So I'm gonna put the top on them. I don't want to put the sun. It's like the middle of the day, and one of the things I totally covered up, and then I realized I think air is very important. So if you totally cover this up, I mean, how are they gonna get the air? There's no holes down in the bottom. Their holes are at the top. So I thought I'd leave this just loose, and maybe that's why the gnats get to it, but then I don't really care. Are the gnats hurting anything? And are they gnats or fruit flies? You tell me. I don't know if that's too close to focus, but see, maybe zoom in. Can you see it? Is it focusing? Automatic focus, maybe? Automatic focus on. Maybe holding it still. I don't know. How would I know? My eyes are not that good. All right. Three. I think I'm eating one. Let's see, I'm gonna cover this all up and put it back.